Welcome back.
Well, we're either all going to be, well, we will be in the situation one time or another, mm-hmm. or maybe you have been, when it comes to caring for your aging parent. You know, the roles kind of reverse. Mm-hmm. You know, first they cared for us, and now it's time for us to care for them. But what are some of the things that we need to deal with when caring for an aging parent? You know, how do we know when they're supposed to be staying at home, when they're supposed to be going somewhere? Should they go somewhere? All the red tape of caregiving and whatnot. Well, I tell you, there is one advocate who is here to share her thoughts and her experiences with us. I want to say good morning to author Carolyn Brent joining us this morning. Good morning, Carolyn. It's great to see you.
Good morning. It's an honor to be on your show.
Well, thank you so much. You know, we talked briefly on the phone the other day. You have a new book out. I want to make sure we tell people what this is called. The Caregiver's Companion, Caring for Your Loved One Medically, Financially, and Emotionally While Caring for Yourself. I love those last words, caring for yourself. People don't think about that, do they, Carolyn?
Well, often when caregivers are kind of thrown in the situation, we forget about ourselves because we're so busy concentrating on our loved ones. We want them to be well, but we as caregivers, we work, we go to school, we have babies and grandkids, so we think that we're super people, and we're not. That is why I wrote the book, to help the caregivers to take care of self. And I'm 58 years old, so I do believe that I know what I'm talking about because I'm 58. And see these muscles?
Yes, girlfriend.
I didn't know we're going to see a gun show today.
Had a great one at that.
How do you talk to your parent? At what age and how early and how often without being offensive and approaching that, your parent?
Well, my father had the first conversation with me when I was 18. I didn't want to hear it. I thought, Dad, you're only 50. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to talk about it. But we as Americans, we never want to talk about it at any age. So what I share with people as an expert, whoever decides that they're going to have that crucial conversation with mom and dad, have your own paperwork in order. And what I simply mean, it's easier to have a conversation with the traditionalist, and a traditionalist is someone that was that's 67 on up. They have been taught you don't talk about your health, you don't talk about your age, your life is a secret. So they become resistant if you come and go, oh, mom and dad, where's your money? Let me help you. You can't approach it like that. Right. So the way, get your own paperwork into order first. You need a medical proxy just in case something happens to you. So what I would do if I were you, I'd say, mom and dad, you know what? I went down and I spoke with XYZ attorney, a geriatric attorney, and she put together this really wonderful kit for me. Can I share it with you? Well, mom and dad, if when something happens to me, this is what I have in place, and then you show them. It's called showing and telling. Then the parents are interested, and that's when you say, well, mom and dad, what are your final wishes? That's how you have that conversation. You ease into it. You can't just slam dunk and dump the parents, because that's when they're going to say, oh, Sally Sue's trying to take my money and all they're trying to steal from me. Mm-hmm. You could avoid that altogether when we go approach it as experts in our own family. Mm-hmm. I've done my homework, mom and dad. Look, this is going to make everything easy because we want to create family legacy. Everybody wants that. Family legacy.
Yeah, perfect. What about that's awesome advice. Siblings getting on the same page with your brothers and sisters?
Oh, Lordy, that's a good one. I got to tell you, there was eight of us, and I was the only one back in the 90s that did not have children, and I wasn't married. They said, that a girl, Carolyn, you could take care of that dad. You have nothing else better to do. Mm. So I did it because I love my daddy. Mm. But on the back end of caregiving, then the siblings wanted to get involved, and I found myself not in one court, not two, but three. So I've discovered there's something known as a sibling contract. What that simply means, when the siblings, the adult sibling says, Mary Sue, you do the dishes or I'm going to handle the banking. You don't want anyone handling the banking if they file bankruptcy, they're a very bad money manager. Mm-hmm. You get everything in writing up front. And if the family cannot resolve it, that's when you get a third party, just a mediator, someone that knows how to avoid the tricky things of caregiving because of this. Caregiving is the easy part. I always say it's easy because, you know, we just got to let the professionals help us with caring for our parents. Mm-hmm. The hard part is getting through the legal, the financial, and the medical field. If you don't know what questions to ask or what safeguards to have in place, then that's when it becomes difficult, crazy, and it's a mess. Mm-hmm. So with the Caregiver's Companion, there's over 1,500 caregivers worldwide with their stories, and there's geriatric doctors, and there's and also financial advisors. These are all certified. In other words, they're not somebody that does everything plus the kitchen sink. They specialize in one area, and then they went to school even beyond the call of duty to make themselves a certified attorney geriatric, or a certified geriatric doctor, or a certified geriatric something if you're dealing with geriatrics. So I have everything in order. I do not have children. I am not married. So I would be a prime candidate for a family member to just take all my things, but I put all my things in what is known as a trust. And I call it a big old fat Christmas tree box. And anything that I want people to have or do, it's in the trust, which is just nothing but a big gift box. So once I expire, or let's say I get sick, they can open up the gift box and see who my executor is and said, Carolyn doesn't want to be on life support. Instead of guessing, right, you want to take all the guessing work out. And also, I don't want the state to have a stranger to make decisions for me. So everybody should get their paperwork in order. And I'm speaking of legal documents. I'm not talking about something that's written on a piece of paper, because half the things are not even, you hear a family saying, well, dad wrote it on a piece of paper. Guess what? The judge is gonna say, and what? So we have to take our own responsibility, and we got to take care of ourselves.
And we're going to talk a little bit more about that, Carolyn. You have some super tips. We're going to take a quick break and come back with Carolyn Brent right after this, friends. So stay with us.